G'day everyone. We've been traveling the world for 4 years in our four-wheel camper and Land Rover Defender. We love the outdoors, nature, hiking, and we're also passionate rock climbers. What do we do to stay fit and healthy whilst living life full-time on the road? In this video, I'm just gonna focus on the gear we use and how we stay motivated, along with a few other topics on maintaining our health and fitness whilst living full-time in a camper. Our training kit comprises of a suspension trainer, two elastic band resistance trainers with handles, a skipping rope, or a jump rope as I know it's called in some parts of the world, an awesome woody rock climbing fingerboard, a gym mat, a few various sized elastic band rings, and a set of forearm strengthening grips. Our entire training kit is super lightweight and compact, fitting into one small bag and stored in Grizzly's side boxes. Let's talk motivation. For me, the key to my training is early mornings. During the summer months, I typically wake up around 3:30 a.m. I'll make a coffee and by 4:30 a.m. I'll be training. I love early mornings to be awake before the rest of the world, watch that sun come up every single day. I also know from experience that if I get my training done first thing in the morning, there's less chance that I'm gonna make an excuse not to do it as the day goes by. I do encourage everyone to give early mornings a try, not necessarily for training, but just to be out in that stillness, that time before everybody else. If you find getting up early in the morning hard to do, go to bed earlier. Finding the motivation to train regularly. If it's cold outside, snowing, raining, too hot, or maybe we're just in a terrible location. Of course, we do have the days where we just cannot seem to get into it. On these days, I've found it helps to have a highly motivational figure, someone that inspires you. At the moment, I'm obsessed with a bloke named David Goggins. I've been following Goggins now for about 12 months on social media, and I recently started listening to his book. A little word of warning, if you do check out David Goggins, he uses a lot of bad language and his method of motivation can be quite confronting. I love his raw, abusive, no pity, no excuses attitude. Music is also a big motivator for me. As soon as I get out of bed in the morning, I wash my face with cold water, I make a coffee, and I put the headphones in. Nothing motivates me more than hardcore metal music at 4 a.m. in the morning. Location challenges. Full-time overlanding means that our backyard is constantly changing. Now this can be an awesome thing for training, but it can also present some challenges. Waking up in the middle of the mountains overlooking a beautiful lake makes training and exercising a pleasure. Training in a city car park or on the side of the road in a noisy truck stop makes it a bit more difficult. This took some getting used to at the beginning and definitely led to a lot of skipped training days. These days, I love the fact that my playground is always different. There's not too many people that can say they did a workout in the middle of the Caspian Sea on a 5-day shipping voyage. So how do we train? What do we do? Stephy is currently working her way through a long-term YouTube program called Epic. Using YouTube or a training app, for example, is a great way to stay motivated whilst following a regular schedule. For me, all of my training exercises are in my head and they alternate between core strength and cardio. My favorite piece of training equipment is by far the suspension trainer. In fact, if I had to take a bare basic training kit comprising of only one item, the suspension trainer would be it. You can hang this thing anywhere. A tree, a playground, the roof rack of the Defender, or even a door frame. For my cardio, I love to run. Preferably in the mountains on trails, but I'll run in cities also. If I have to run in a city, then I'll always look for a river or a long distance bike path or walking path to avoid running on vehicle roads. There are countless ways to keep fit with no equipment. Take a look on YouTube at body weight only core strength and cardio sessions. You'll be amazed at what is possible. Some of the exercises are absolutely brutal and body weight training is so good for you. In the end, it's hard to beat the good old push-ups and sit-ups. Skipping or jump rope is also fantastic cardio. Using an interval timer, I'll alternate between skipping, core strength like planking, box jumps, burpees, etc. Trying to maintain a regular training schedule is important. I try to train at least 3 to 4 times a week, with each session being roughly an hour to an hour and a half. Never on any set days, because sometimes there will be days where it's just not possible. Overlanding or full-time travel whilst practicing a sport is also a great way to keep fit and active. As you guys probably know, we like to rock climb. Rock climbing is a fantastic sport to pursue whilst traveling. In fact, we've been traveling all over the world rock climbing for the last 12 years. A basic sport climbing kit for 2 people fits easily in 1 backpack. Rock climbing takes you to the most remote and spectacular places on the planet and can be found in just about every country. We've met travelers that are into all kinds of awesome activities that keep them fit and active whilst on the road. Cycling, mountain biking, surfing, skateboarding, snorkeling, swimming, paragliding and kayaking. These are just a few of the passions pursued by travelers that we've met. Training whilst on a long-term journey like ours can be a lot of fun. Sometimes you have to get creative, use your imagination, make your surroundings, make wherever you are at that particular time your own personal gym. Nature is sometimes your playground. I'll use rocks, trees, the beach, sand, anything. We don't carry any weights with us, but we'll use a rock sometimes. Stephy will use a water bottle, sometimes the water container. Even Land Rover Defender parts can be utilized to train with. Sometimes even the Defender itself. I'll hang my suspension trainer from a tree branch. I'll do pull-ups from a tree branch. In Seoul, in Korea, they had fantastic public free gyms for anyone to use. The benefits are endless to maintaining a fit and healthy lifestyle whilst you travel. Being able to walk around a city all day long and not feel completely exhausted at the end of the day. Walk to the top of that mountain, walk to the top of that lookout. You'll be spending a lot of time on your bum driving that overland vehicle if you're doing something like what we're doing. So I think at a bare minimum, even doing a bit of stretching in the morning and evening can be hugely beneficial. If you're planning an extended overland journey and you're just not interested in training or taking extra equipment, maybe you don't pursue or follow any passions or sports, but maybe you want to still maintain a relatively good level of fitness, I think the best way to do this is hiking. Now, this doesn't even have to be serious hiking in the mountains, although we do highly recommend short and long distance hikes in nature. Not only are you exploring a new area, but you're getting the heart rate up in a beautiful setting. Walk, walk, and walk some more. Walk everywhere. Instead of driving or taking public transport, for example, to explore a new city, you'd be surprised at how much distance you will cover exploring a city on foot for the day. Stephy will usually put her Runtastic app on when we explore a city for a day, and we'll often cover 15 to 20 kilometers. Now, we didn't make this video to preach to you about keeping fit and healthy. You don't need me telling you about the benefits of leading a healthy lifestyle. I do believe you will enjoy a long-term journey such as ours a whole lot more by maintaining a relatively good level of fitness. Not to mention, you can enjoy all of that fantastic food you're going to encounter along the way with a little bit less guilt. In the end though, it's all about having fun and enjoying your own personal journey. Training whilst traveling full-time is very much part of our routine and we enjoy it immensely. On the other hand, we don't take ourselves so seriously that we're going to lose any sleep if we miss a day here and there. We'd love to hear from you, so please do leave a comment with your own methods of training whilst you're away from home, on holiday, or on a long-term overland journey. Thank you kindly for watching this video. Please give us a like and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. We'd really appreciate it. See you all next time. Bye bye.